welcome to Birthing Naturally with Dr. Mahima Bakshi. Today I have with me a special guest from Madhukar Rainbow Children's Hospital, New Delhi. So I have with me Dr. Naveen Gupta, Senior Consultant, Neonatology, Rainbow Children's Hospital, Delhi. Hi sir, welcome to the show. How are you?
I'm good. Thank you, Mahima. Thanks for inviting me on the show.
Thank you, sir. So please tell us something about yourself.
I'm Dr. Naveen. I'm looking after NICU. We have one of the largest NICU in Delhi NCR. And I have done my neonatal training first from Gangaram Hospital. I did my DNB in neonatology there. And then I went overseas. I did my fellowship in neonatology from BC Children's Hospital, Vancouver, from Canada. And then I was previously working in Max Propagand. I was taking care of NICU there. And now since the inception of this hospital, I'm in Madhukar Rainbow Children Hospital since last 2 years.
So sir, with such a vast experience, how does it feel to be now, looking after the entire neonatology team, especially in the children's hospital?
So it actually feels great. We do all kind of works. We have all the facilities and around 500 grams, 24 weeks are our lowest survival. And we cater newborns from Delhi, NCR and the adjoining districts also. We have a very strong transport system, so it feels really nice to be a part of Madhukar Rainbow Children Hospital.
That's wonderful, sir. But now that we are all stuck in this pandemic where COVID-19 cases are on a rise and now even a lot of pregnant women are coming up and being tested positive for COVID-19. So sir, now please can you tell us something about how a delivery is managed, the newborn care is managed when in case a suspected or a COVID positive mother comes for a delivery?
Right, so the protocols have been laid down mainly in India by National Neonatology Forum, IAP and FOCSI. So the first document was laid down in the month of March and the recent updation has come in 7th of May. The American protocol and the European protocol are a little bit different. So we being a private setup, I will tell you what we are following in our hospital. So when a pregnant mother comes to us and we don't know about her COVID status, so we deliver her in an area which we have earmarked separately for suspect COVID patients. So there on the second floor we have the facility, we have a labor room there and the patient is being brought there, and then when the mother delivers, the neonatal team person, he is ready with the full PPE. And the full PPE means either N95 with the face shield and the eye shield with the non-permeable gown and the full PPE or the use of PAP. There is a resuscitation corner which actually should be separate from the mother bed. So we have a neonatal resuscitation corner which is separate from the labor room and the wall is demarcating them. And suppose in some nursing home where this facility is not there, then there should be a difference of at least 2 meters between the resuscitation corner and the mother bed.
Okay, sir. And also now under these circumstances, should the husband be present during the labor or should it not happen?
So I think video consult and this advances in technology, we should utilize that. So husband should not be present there, rather he can communicate to the wife through the online thing.
Right,
that should be the need of our and that should be done.
Right, sir. So also sir, tell us about when the baby is born and post that, how do we ensure that whether that baby needs to undergo a testing for COVID or not and what protocols are followed in that case?
Right. So wonderful question, Mahima. So when the baby is being born, what different do we do in babies who are born to mother who have suspect COVID or COVID positive? So first is, like in a normal case when we encourage so much skin to skin care, here we tend to defer that skin to skin care. Secondly, there has been an ongoing debate about whether the cord clamping should be immediate or delayed. As we say that for normal babies it should be delayed. In this suspect COVID or COVID positive mother, when the baby is being born, right now till date there have been no case report apart from one which has documented vertical transmission. So if we say that vertical transmission don't happen, then the benefits of delayed cord clamping, they outweigh the risk of transmission of the COVID. So cord clamping should be delayed if the baby cries immediately. If the baby needs resuscitation, the clamping should be done immediately and baby should be taken to resuscitation care. So these are two aspects which differ. Then even before delivery, we should have a lengthy talk with the parents that which approach they should do. Normally we can get out for, chalk down about three approaches. First approach is where the parents, they don't want to give any risk of COVID to the baby. So in that approach, mother and baby are kept totally separate till the time mother, at least two cultures are negative and she gets asymptomatic. And she pumps and dumps her milk, the baby receives formula from a nurse or from a caretaker who is COVID negative. So in this approach, we are totally abolishing the risk of transmission. Normally, so far data suggests that from the breast milk, the transmission doesn't happen. Rather, breast milk transmits antibodies. So the middle approach, that seems most reasonable in our Indian scenario. And that approach is that we give mother the option of that the baby is either nursed separate or nursed in the same room with a 2 meter distance. She washes her breast, she wears mask and washes hand, and then she expresses her milk. And that expressed breast milk is being given to the baby by a caretaker or by a nurse who is COVID negative. The third approach, which is actually good in the public setup and which also we can discuss with the parents, the third approach actually enhances the mother-baby bonding. In that approach, if the mother is not symptomatic or not sick, then she stays with the baby. She breastfeeds the baby, but while breastfeeding, she takes care of a proper hygiene, like she washes her hand before, she wears a mask, and she has a full idea that the virus is not being transmitted through the breast milk, but it's mainly the fomite transmission or the postnatal transmission can happen. Now, another thing which happens, or the debate which is occurring, is what is the ideal time to test these babies? So A is, first we should know that which baby need to be tested. If we know that the mother was COVID positive within 14 days before delivery, or postnatally we know that there is a history of contact, then the baby should be tested. Previous guidelines suggested that the test should be done first at 24 hours. Now the recent, this NNF FOXI guideline, they say that baby should be tested immediately after birth or as soon as possible. And a second test should be done somewhere between 5 to 14 days. Now, when should the baby be discharged from the hospital? If the baby remains asymptomatic and the mother is also not sick, then the mother and baby should be discharged from the hospital as soon as possible, say after 48 hours. If suppose the baby becomes symptomatic and the baby is being taken care of, then once the symptoms goes off and the baby is being tested twice negative, then the baby should be discharged from the hospital. So this was a little bit lengthy, but this actually includes all the majority of the neonatal care which we should provide to a mother who is COVID suspect or COVID positive.
So that's some amazing information, I think, which our viewers watching would definitely be able to share it with other pregnant moms or new moms in case there are any in their family. Any extra care that these moms need to take care once they go back home, or extra care by the family that needs to be taken care of?
Yeah, I think like we normally suggest that mother-baby diet should be, they ate together for 42 days. So in this scenario, this is a specific scenario where the number of visitors should be minimized, because postnatally baby is going to get COVID from them only. And secondly, like we say that lot of newborn caretakers, the japas, so they should be preferably be either discouraged, or they should be first tested that they are COVID negative, and then only they should take care of the newborn.
Right, sir. And how does it affect the bonding? Then how a mother can, utilize other ways, or once the tests have come out to be negative, and then when the mother can spend more time with the baby, what extra things can she do to bond with the baby in a better way? Because immediate bonding in such cases are a little, being getting challenged because of proximity issues. So what else can the mother do once the baby can be given to her?
Yeah, I think this is an excellent question. So mother should try. So Kangaroo mother care is one way. With the Kangaroo mother care, the bonding between the mother and baby is enhanced, the breast milk secretion is enhanced. Secondly, the mother should talk to the baby. She should keep the baby at a distance of 15 to 30 centimeter, and she should talk to the baby. The human voice is the best stimulus, and her face, the human face, is the best visual stimulus. So by this, she can provide the visual and auditory stimulus. And once she can massage the baby, then she should do the gentle massage followed by the bathing. This is how she should spend more and more time with the baby. But definitely Kangaroo mother care is one of the best way by which the bonding can be enhanced, by which the chances of successful breastfeeding can be enhanced.
So breastfeeding definitely remains the best option for your baby. However, certain extra care needs to be followed in case you are a suspected case or a positive case of COVID-19. So this was some great information about newborn care during these COVID-19 times, and I would suggest all mothers to please ensure that you try to follow all these tips as much as possible. Sir, any last tip that you would like to share with all the mothers watching us?
So I think prevention is the key, and as we are discussing and as we are listening on the media, the social distancing and our own protection by wearing adequate mask, that is the key.
Yes, and most important, every pregnant mom should try to keep her safe as much as possible. So stay home, stay safe. Thank you so much.
Thank you
so much, sir, for being a part of my show. It was a great pleasure. Thanks
Thank
a lot,
you,
sir.
Thank you, Mayim. Same.
Thank you.